Please introduce yourself.
Joe Harris.
All right, Joe Harris.
Right.
Joe Harris, what brings out the Detroit in you?
Well, what brings the Detroit out of me, I think it comes from the environment and the times that I grew up in Detroit. I was so confident. The confidence that Norman Whitfield had instilled that I was getting from him with the music that we were doing then at that time, that I felt as though I had to become a legitimate voice for that time, the turn in that curve. The way you say it, you knew all these things were happening. Norman, remember now, was coming off a message from a black man. Don't let the Joneses get you down, Cloud Nine, all those kind of things. And remember, Marvin Gaye was coming with What's Going On and all those things that happened during Smiling Faces. In fact, during that time, we got a Grammy at the same time with Marvin Gaye. So all those message songs was out there together, which really fused Motown right up into something that really opened the door to a new Motown. We've always put ourselves right on the edge of the Motown as it was with the original folks, and at the door when the change was starting to come down in Los Angeles Supremes. Eddie was leaving the Temps. Disco was starting to show his face. And then this was right after, during the time when the messages were coming out. And in fact, you know, we came right behind Smiling Faces with You Make Your Own Heaven and Hell, Unite the World, a lot of things that all were message orientated. The way it made me feel is it woke me up to realize that I couldn't fake it. So I had to make myself aware of the times. In fact, I put myself in a lot of things that I had never felt as though I had the time to participate in. In fact, I did participate in a march in the early 60s with Martha Jean and Pete Hogg and when Martin Luther King came here, but everybody in Detroit was here for that. You know, but when things started happening, the riots and stuff, and I was out with Undisputed Truth, I availed myself to do a lot of radio tags and things on air about the times and talking about the times because of the subjects of our musical. Well, I mean, so it really polished our act and even in those entities, the three of us, we never did things that we couldn't do. We were all three lead singers, but we put ourselves together as an act to be able to perform together as three lead singers without stepping in somebody else's lane. In other words, when you're in front, we front ground you, not background you. We front ground you. This is what we used to call it. and wow.
How were the crowds coming to a show knowing the pulse of the people wanted to hear something?
What we don't have right now. And in any interview, that pulse that you're talking about right now is the pulse that black music, any other music other than the music that you're hearing, we had the pulse. We don't have that pulse right now. See, so by me coming out of Detroit, first of all, Detroit was an entity that everybody, as I traveled around the world, was tuned into. Everybody was tuned into the pulse coming out of Detroit. We don't have none that pulse nowhere. The pulse we have right now is a fake. You know, and anybody that that records or make music, you make music, you know, the thing that I had on you is that I could take my stuff down to WCHB, CKLW, and JLB, and they'd be, all of them be playing my music at the same time. We walk in there and people say, what you want? Eddie LaVert just said that on Facebook. He said, I walk in a radio station and they look at me and hug me and talk about me. And then they was like, well, what you want us to do with that record? I said, well, I want y'all to play it. You know, and he said he learned that the radio today is not the radio that it was yesterday. In fact, the radios that we had yesterday were airwaves there for us to be able to display our work.